So they have given a story. Each type of bird has a specific beak, okay? So far we have seen about the wings of a bird, and now we are going to see about the beak of a bird. Each type of bird has a specific beak shape that helps it find and eat food, okay? Have you seen a hen? It will be pricking its beak on the soil, and it will be searching some worms or insects to eat. Birds also use their beak to collect materials to build their nest and to carry food to feed their young ones, okay? So it will go in search of foods with the beak in the soil, and it will give its young ones. Baby birds use their beaks to break out of its eggs, okay? If it is a egg is there, and how a baby young one of a bird will come out of the egg, it will knock the shell of the egg and it will break it and it will come out of the egg. Okay, so see here some of the types of beaks which are there, which are birds are having. Falcon's beak is hooked at its tip. See here, it is like a hook. It helps to tear the meat of the prey. Birds like falcon are called predators, okay? These birds will be having some meat as food. So in order to tear the meat, its hooks are like a bended structure and it is like a hook. See here, swan. Swan's beak is like a filter, okay? It will go deep into the water, and along with the mud, it will catch its prey, and after catching its prey, it will filter all its mud down and it will have its prey on its beak, okay? Swan's beak is flat and acts like a strainer. It helps sort through its food and mud and water, as I have said you now. A woodpecker's beak is sharp and acts like a chisel or a drill. It is very sharp, okay? It acts like a chisel, okay? It will go deeply into the wood for pricking the wood, okay? It is a woodpecker. It is used to peck at hard fruits and bark of the trees for insects. The spoonbill. Next one is spoonbill's beak is shaped like a spoon. Okay, see there? It is like a spoon. It acts like a shovel or a scoop that digs out tiny fish and other food from water. It will go deep into the water and it will dig the water and it will catch its prey. Okay, so next one is hummingbird. A hummingbird's beak is long and shaped like a drinking straw. See there, it is like a straw. It will go into the flower and it will suck the nectar from the flower. A swallow. See, it's a swallow. Its beak is like a small, its beak is small and sharp. It can open its mouth wide to catch the insects out of air, and it also eats small fruits. So a grosbeak has a short and conical beak. It is strong and used to crack and open nuts and seeds, okay? It is like a short and conical shape. It is used for cracking the nuts. See, it is the beak of a heron. Heron's beak is long and pointed like a spear. It is very sharp and it's like a spear. It is used to pick fish and other animals out of the water, okay? It will point out the fish and it will prick it and it will take it out of the water. So next one is, now we are going to, first we have seen about the feathers, second one we have seen about the beaks, and third one we are going to see about the claws, feet and claws. Okay, now we are going to see about the feet of the birds. See here, these type of feet are used for climbing and these type of feet are used for swimming. And see here, it has two toes that point forward. See here, forward, and two toes that point backwards like shape of an X. Helps the birds grasp the trunk of the tree and climb. Pedaling, has skin that stretches out connecting the toes called webbed feet, okay? This is a type of feet which ducks having. It is for swimming. Helps the bird paddle in the water. This is the grasping, okay? It has strong feet and long curved claws. It for grasping. Helps the bird capture, grasp and kill the prey. Eagles, hawks, okay, they will grasp the prey and it will tear it. See here, it is wadding. It has long fingers, like it is called as toes. Helps the bird walk in water and in wetlands. Herons, cranes are having long toes. Perching. It has three toes that point forward and one that points backward. It helps the bird perch on trees, walk and hop, okay? Swallows, crows, these will having this kind of feet. And this is called as strong feet with only two toes, helps the birds run very fast. Okay, ostriches and emus. Okay, it is for running. Okay, so far we have seen about feathers, beaks and toes. So these are some activities given for you. And next we are going to see about the nests. Okay, for nest, birds will live in nests. Birds usually build nests by collecting different materials around them using their beaks. Birds lay their eggs in nests and keep the eggs warm until it's hatched. Birds usually look after the babies until they are ready to fly on their own. Different birds build different kinds of nests. Let us look at some types of nests. Okay, have you seen a crow or a bird building its own nest? Okay, now we are going to see about the nest of a bird. See here, first one. Most birds such as crow build their nest using twigs, some twigs of a tree. They make the insides of the nest soft using materials such as papers, flowers, moss and grass. Okay, these are the things which are used to build its nest. And next one, penguin. Penguins build their nest by placing stones and pebbles directly on the ground. Because they are living in polar region, it will use some stones and pebbles for building its nest. Okay, so it is a weaver bird. Okay, Thookanangkuruvi. The weaver bird's nest is shaped like a vase. It is like a flower vase. It is woven together using dry gas. The bird enters the nest through the tube-like opening at the bottom. Okay, it is a very brilliant bird which makes its nest very nicely. Okay, it builds its nest like a skillful engineer. So some worksheets are given here. And so far we have seen about the birds, okay, the winged wonders. For that we have seen about its feathers, its beaks, its claws and about its nest, okay. So we hope you enjoyed this lesson and hope you have a clear idea about what are birds and what are the winged wonders of this earth, okay. Thank you for watching and keep on reading this lesson more and more. Thank you.